The price of Bitcoin has absolutely exploded, pushing up to nearly $37,000 per coin with this upcoming ETF approval that's going to be nearly 100% approved. This is amazing news. This upcoming bull run is going to be fantastic for crypto. We're going to be going over this 4-year cycle for Bitcoin. I'm going to be showing you some major trading signals, so make sure you like, subscribe, leave a comment, and tap that notification bell to stay up to date with all of the future videos. When we look at Bitcoin right now, clearly on the weekly time frame, which is the major time frame that I like to look at, especially for this upcoming bull run, we look at this exponential moving average clearly trending to the upside. We had a slight little scare in this area where the downtrend in the EMA definitely did come through. We even broke below this low. You can see right in this level, a lot of stops were in this level. People got stopped out of the market, and then look what happened. The market has rallied completely to the opposite level of their stop. So from this level all the way to the upside, you see Bitcoin's up over 50%, and there were so many people that put stops in this level. Bang, already their position down 50%, because they would be up 50% if they stayed in their long. So absolutely crazy price action that's been happening for Bitcoin. Next thing that I really want to show you is this upcoming 4-year bull cycle for Bitcoin. When we absolutely scroll out, we can see every single 4-year bull cycle, every single piece of price action that's ever happened for Bitcoin that's readily available on one exchange. When we actually scroll in and see the first 4-year cycle, you can see that Bitcoin actually follows cycles of 3 years of bull markets and 1 year of bear markets. So you can actually see where we had all this. The actual beginning of Bitcoin was back here in this 2011 region. You can see that the beginning of Bitcoin was actually right here on this date, back in this date here. We actually scroll in, we can see overall we had 150 bars of bull market to the upside, where we had continuous upside momentum. Then at this point here, we began to reverse, and you can see we had basically 58 bars. You see, we go up for 150 bars, we go down for basically 50 bars. So we go up for 3/4, and we go down for 1/4. So you can see that's the overall 4-year cycle, where we have 3 years of bull market and 1 year of bear market, overall totaling that 4-year cycle. You can then see the end of this cycle right through here. We then scroll in, we look at this price again, 150 bars to the upside. Let's look at the entire cycle, was 200 bars. So again, 150 bars to the upside, and we had 50 bars to the downside, clearly showing exactly what's happening in Bitcoin. We're following this 4-year Bitcoin cycle, where we continuously have this upside momentum, where we look at this exponential moving average clearly trending to the upside. And again, we've got the end of the 4-year cycle, where we begin trending to the upside, which was this last Bitcoin cycle right here in this area, going through into this 2020 region all the way through to close to 2022. So again, we look at this region right through here. Again, 152 bars to the upside. The total 4-year cycle was 206. So again, 150 bars to the upside and 50 bars to the downside. This was the end of the 4-year cycle and the most important part. So right here, you can see 150 bars to the upside is the end of this green bar right here, and that's what's expected. 3 years of bull cycles to the upside, and then what is expected? 1 year of bear market cycles to the downside. So what we're expecting is over this $100,000 per Bitcoin price. The reason being is because we actually do a 1618 extension. We use this Fibonacci extension all the way from the low that happened into 2019, all the way to the high that happened in late 2021, late 2021, bring it down to this current low in this area. Look at where this 1618 perfectly lines up with. The 1618 lines up with $120,000 to $130,000 per Bitcoin, which is where I think is absolutely the fantastic level for Bitcoin to go. The reason that this $120,000 per Bitcoin is fantastic is because right now Bitcoin has a $500 billion market cap. And if we were to go $120,000 per coin, that would put Bitcoin at a $2 trillion market cap, which is actually pretty significant and would make a lot of sense, especially when we get this ETF approval. We get a lot of sophisticated investors, old school investors that have never invested in Bitcoin, never even wanted to invest in Bitcoin. They can now get into Bitcoin in the traditional finance sense, because they can invest in the stock market into this Bitcoin ETF, and then the Bitcoin ETF company is going to have to then purchase in the real market the equivalent worth of this Bitcoin for these old school investors. All of a sudden, that's going to drive the price of Bitcoin up, and I do believe we can easily get a 4x in this upcoming bull market, putting Bitcoin from that $30,000 level that I was initially talking about for for a long, long time, then to that $120,000 level, 4x for Bitcoin, putting that, locking it up, and even earning some yield on that. Absolutely fantastic. That's why I'm getting into Bitcoin. That's why I'm into crypto. This is absolutely fantastic gains. All the gains are happening right now. You need to be in the market. And if you're not, you need to make sure you have my trading course so you understand exactly how to be trading. So very, very exciting. Make sure you're already into your positions. If you're not into your positions, you want to be buying back when we come back to retest this exponential moving average, because that's the average price. You can see all through these areas, we have continuous upside momentum. And all through these areas, you think, oh my God, we're never coming back to the average price. We're just going to keep rocketing to the upside. Even in this area, oh, we're just going to keep rocketing to the upside. I need to buy high. I need to buy high. So you need to understand in the market that we are going to have some big ups. We're going to have some small downs, some big ups, some small downs. And in these small downs is where you really want to be looking to buy. Rather than buying right now at this $35,000 level, you really would be buying high in the market when the overall average price right here is $28,000. So you'd look at the average price all through this level through here. Average price was $24,000, but the overall price was trading at $30,000. But eventually you can see the overall average price came back to $25,800 and then price matched it. So it wasn't going to match it down here at $24,000, but it matched it here at $25,000, although it was already at $30,000, and very, very similar here. The price was already up here at this $32,000 level, where the average price was at $27,000. So there's a good $5,000 difference between the average price. And even if you got in here, perfect. Rather than buying up here, this $32,000 level, at least you got in at $28,000, although you could have bought at $24,000. But again, you're looking to buy at the average price. So rather than be buying up here when the price right now is $34,000, close to $35,000, overall average price is about $6,000 away. Do you really want to be buying now? No, I'd wait for a small little decline where price comes back to here, potentially using this as a bit of support to resistance level flip. We have resistance in the market. We've broken through this resistance level. We might have a small downtick into this area. Then at least, rather than buying at 34, close to 35,000, at least you get in at 31,000. All of a sudden, you're saving $3,000-$4,000 per Bitcoin. Maybe buy one Bitcoin. Even if you get half a Bitcoin, all of a sudden, you're making savings in the market. That's what you continuously need to do, especially when you're dollar cost averaging. Maybe you want to enter 5% of your position over multiple months. So it means you're going to be entering basically 20 different positions, or overall you'll be averaging the price. That's actually a good strategy overall, depending on your overall trading strategy. Maybe you want to be short-term trading. I like to be short-term and long-term trading. I have a long-term stack where I'm only looking at the weekly time frame, only trading in the long-term direction of the weekly trend. Then I have a short-term trading strategy where I go to the daily and I look at the daily trend. So I can see right now the daily trend is trending to the upside. So now when I go to the 30-minute time frame, okay, I'm only trading to the direction of the trend. I wait for a small push to the upside. Okay, look for enters on this exponential moving average on this 30-minute time frame. So you can see how I'm actually anticipating the market. I'm using these daily and weekly time frames to understand which is the overall direction of the trend. I know that the overall direction of the trend is up. Now that I want to trade the 5-minute time frame, I'm only going to be trading in the long-term direction, which is the upside direction. So when I see a potential trade to the downside in this area, rather than selling, I'm going to be exiting any of my positions that I am in to the long side. And then I'll be looking for some buy positions. Down in this area, we get a bit of a 1, 2, 3, 4 push wedge. We then get a 5 push of a wedge. You can see all through this area, once we get the 3 push, that'd be an enter for a trade. Once we get the 4th push, not sure, because usually they enter in 3s, 5s, and 7s. All of a sudden, we get the 5th push. That's where I enter into the trade and only looking for longs. All of a sudden, on this potential trade, probably 0.5%, 0.75%. At least I'm only trading in the long-term direction. Now, it just makes the probability of trading, even on these smaller time frames, such high probability. And at least you know if the long-term direction has a high probability of going to the upside, then these small-term time frames definitely have that higher probability, and you're going to have just more consistent trades only trading in the direction of the long-term trend when you get that exact trading signal. That's why you need to have my trading masterclass at 50% off. I teach you every single trading strategy that I know and I'm super successful with in the market. Make sure to smash the like, subscribe, leave a comment, tap that notification bell, and I'll see you in the next video.